Becoming a perfect blackjack player is just the first step to making money as a card counter. In this video, I'm going to explain three skills every blackjack player must have if they want to really make it as a card counter. I'm Colin from Blackjack Apprenticeship, and over my years playing blackjack, running teams, and running Blackjack Apprenticeship, I've seen a lot of card counters come and go. Some of them make some good money at it, thousands or hundreds of thousands, and a few make even more than that, while others just don't make it. Why? Does the system not work anymore? Are casinos just too smart now? Do you need to have a massive bankroll to make it as a card counter? Absolutely not. 99% of the time, when I find a card counter doesn't make money, it's because they lack one of these three skills. Let me break them down for you. The first skill every card counter needs is the ability to gain and calculate the edge. Gaining the edge means having a perfect game at all four phases: perfect basic strategy, perfect counting, perfect betting, and perfect playing deviations. And I'm gonna be honest with you, a lot of people, I'd say the majority of people that get interested in card counting, don't take the time to master their skills. They go to the casino before they're ready, they don't have the edge, and of course they're not gonna make money. If you lack the discipline or just don't put in the time necessary to master every phase as a card counter, you're not gonna make it. Beyond gaining the edge, you have to be able to calculate the edge. What that means is you need to know the edge and the EV of every game you're gonna play before you play at a casino. And I see a lot of new card counters playing games that they really shouldn't be playing. Whether that's online casinos that have terrible rules, terrible deck penetration, and are really slow, and you're not gonna make any money at online casinos, or card counters that are trying to play 6 to 5 blackjack games, or casinos where they cut off way too many cards for it to be worthwhile. You really can make money as a card counter, but not if you're playing really crappy games out there. So if you wanna make it as a card counter, you need to both perfect your skills before you go into the casino and know which casinos to play and what your edge is before going in. That's why we spent 6 figures on software at Blackjack Apprenticeship the last few years, because when I started as a card counter, I didn't have good training software and I didn't know the edge of the games I was going to play. And I was playing some casinos that were a break-even game at best, and I just wasted my time basically gambling because I didn't know any better. So we've developed training software so that someone can test himself out virtually before going into a casino. And we've created a casino database with the house edge of every casino in the country, because not all games are created equally, and you can't just walk into a casino and assume that you're gonna have positive EV, or maybe it's positive EV but barely, and your risk is gonna be through the roof. If you can't pass a virtual test out, and if you don't know the edge of the game you're gonna play before you go into a casino, you really shouldn't be putting your bankroll at risk. The second life skill every card counter needs is the ability to get hours in the casino. If you don't have time to actually play in casinos, then card counting might be a nice mental exercise, but it does take hours to reach the long run. Part of getting hours in, and I've created videos specifically on backoffs, but you have to be able to get hours in regardless of casino heat and backoffs. To me, this is a combination of a few things. It's one, being able to fit in a casino, so you can't be all shifty-eyed and, you know, handshaking when you place a bet and freak out the first time a pit boss is looking your direction. You have to be able to fit in and be able to handle the environment. You also have to be able to have kind of like a spidey sense of how much heat you're getting. If the phone's ringing, they're staring at you, you have to know, hey, when is it time to move on to the next casino versus stay there and play through the heat. You also have to know which casinos are going to be able to tolerate the action. Some casinos freak out the first time you raise your bet. Other casinos, they can handle a little bit of money moving on the table. And then finally, you have to have incredibly thick skin. The reality is, if you're a good card counter, you will get backed off. And I've trained players for the church team or through Blackjack Apprenticeship that they can play perfectly at home. But once they get to the casino, the heat, the stress of the environment, it's just not a good fit. And there's nothing wrong with that. But if you want to make it and make money as a card counter, you have to be able to execute the skills with knowing that there's going to be heat and there are going to be backoffs. The third life skill of a card counter is bankroll management. And I've said it before, but a card counter needs two skills. They need their brains and their bankroll. We've talked about the brains part. That's having a perfect game. It's being smart about getting hours in and all that stuff. But there's the bankroll piece also. If you don't manage that piece, you will lose your money. And let me tell you a short story. There are two card counters that I knew. I trained through a boot camp. This is a number of years ago. One of them goes by the name the Phoenix. The other, we'll call him Scorpio. And these guys, they met at the boot camp, they exchanged info, and they finished their training together, and they decided to team up as a two-man card counting team. The problem was they couldn't agree on how much risk they should take on with their bankroll. The Phoenix, he was a little bit older and you might say wiser, and he didn't want his risk to be very high because he knew, hey, it might take a little longer to generate EV, but if our risk is too high, we could lose our bankroll and then we can't make any money. Scorpio, he was like 21 years old and ambitious young buck, and he said, hey, let's play with, I don't remember what it was, but the risk was a bit high. And the reason he wanted to is because, yeah, the more you bet, the more you can make. And he said, we're probably not going to be, you know, the one in 10 that loses his money. And they couldn't agree on this. So they played for a while and they decided to split up, go their separate ways. The Phoenix, he continued to keep his risk low. And you can listen to podcast interviews I've done with him, or he was on Gambling with an Edge at least once. This guy has gone on to win many hundreds of thousands as a card counter by keeping his risk low and getting hours in at the tables. Now, Scorpio, he went out there with higher risk and he ran his bankroll from like $5,000 up to $50,000, kept playing, started losing, didn't want to decrease his risk, and he lost his entire bankroll. And when you lose your bankroll, you can't generate any EV. The point is, you have to manage your risk. The reality is, if you play long enough, you're going to have both winning streaks and losing streaks. And if you don't have the bankroll management to withstand those losing streaks, you're just not going to make it. Card counting is a marathon, not a sprint. It takes time to get in the hours to get to the long run. You might start winning right away, but if you start losing and you don't have the proper bankroll management, you're going to lose everything. There are a few places you can go to learn more about bankroll management. The first is an article I wrote on Blackjack Apprenticeship. We'll put the link below, but it's called Recommended Blackjack Bankroll. It's a big article I spent a lot of time on. It's got a lot of numbers in there of different bankroll sizes and the corresponding EV and risk. And it's just a high level article. They'll give you a good taste of what bankroll size you might need to keep your risk at different levels. Second, a better tool than that would be our bankroll management app. With that, you can put in your bankroll size, the game you're going to play, and it's going to output different bet spreads and the corresponding EV and risk so that you can maximize your EV and keep your risk as low as possible. The third tool is a software called CVCX by a company called QFIT, and it's really powerful. It can do a lot of things. It's a Windows-based software, and you can run simulations, do all sorts of stuff. So you could check that out as well if that's the direction you want to go. Look, this is just a brief overview of the three skills you're going to need as a card counter. To learn more at Blackjack Apprenticeship, for our members, we have an entire video course, training drills, members forum, casino database, bankroll management app, podcasts, and more. And if you're new to Blackjack Apprenticeship YouTube, make sure you subscribe below so you can get our regular updates and learn what it takes to beat casinos and take their money as a card counter.